astrology soulmates, and welcome to your weekly horoscope for the week of October 5th. Welcome. It's October. We're in a new month. We've just had a full moon. How are you doing? How are you doing after that full moon? Anything starting to come to light, coming to an end already? What have you seen that's maybe needed a little bit of adjustment? Really, as you're going through this week, I would love for you to think back to that new moon that we had last month in Virgo. From there until now, what have you seen a little bit of difference on? Where have you seen some progress? Let me know in the comment section down below. I would love to see what you're getting up to over there. This week is going to be an interesting week. We're going to start out the week. Well, we're going to start out with the energies that I feel are big for this week with a Mercury-Uranus opposition. And I actually love this placement. I have this in my chart. I see it work like fire. I see it move very quickly. There's a lot of creative genius that comes with that, but it doesn't feel that way to everybody. So we'll talk about that in just a minute. Now, this week coming to the Eat and Greets, we've got Miss Clarissa Dolphin coming back, and she is going to look at the presidential candidates' charts, but from a vibrational astrology standpoint. And I haven't seen that happen yet, so I am so proud of her, and I am so ready to share that with you and have that experience with you as well. So we'll be doing that this week as well. Basil Farrington is coming over, you guys. If you have not had a chance to check him out, please Google this man. He is just incredible. I had a chance to meet with him on a project that we're collaborating on with a group of other people, and I was like, you gotta come over to the Eat and Greet. So he comes from the Noel Till line, and just phenomenal. Just phenomenal. So he'll be over this week in the Eat and Greets as well. Cannot wait to share both of these beautiful people in the Cyber House with you. All right, let's talk about what's going up and on in the sky. What's happening up there this week? So as we're getting into the middle of the week, on Wednesday, October 7th, we're going to see Mercury and Uranus come into an opposition with one another. So they're across from one another. So we've got Mercury over here in Scorpio. We've got Uranus over here in Taurus, and they are opposing at 10 degrees. Now, I'm going to tell you, I have this placement in my chart, and I love the way that this energy works. It is fast. It is fire. It is thinking. It is communicating. It is absorbing information very, very quickly. But it's also interesting. I have it in a natal placement, and if you have this as well, I would love to hear how this works or what your experience is of it down below, because I've learned to work with it, and you can master any one of these opposition squares or anything else that you have. But in transit, what it can feel like for us in kind of this global sphere is this energy can feel like communication is not going smoothly, right? It's not smooth. It's not easy. There's maybe something shocking, or there's shocking or surprising news that comes up, which doesn't always have to be bad, but it's just not exactly what you expected. Now, for some people as well, depending on your charts, this is a couple days where you might feel like that anxiety or that tension can be high. Take all of the tactics that you can to just calm your nervous system, hydrate, spend some time with some not a lot of noise on, get some downtime, get into the dark if you can, if that's something that's happening for you. But at the same time, because it switches the tempo of energy just a little bit, this is a great day, I think, to have a breakthrough, or to take an unexpected trip, or to do something in an unexpected way that maybe you wouldn't have done it before. Let the stroke of genius come through this opposition and find the compromise in the middle, because with an opposition, what you want to do is you're not going to be able to pull either side, right? They're pretty equally balanced here. They've equally got pull. So you want to find the compromise in the middle so that these energies can work together and really light up brilliantly. Now, not to mention, I think that as these two are interacting, Mercury's going to step into retrograde. So we're going to see these two come together opposing again, but Mercury will be retrograde at that time, and Uranus will still be retrograde as well. So if you're feeling like there is a little bit of a power struggle going on in this next handful of weeks, or you're trying to think outside of the box and something feels a little bit stuck, just give yourself a little bit of grace, give yourself a little bit of ease with this energy. because they're just trying to get you to come at something from a little bit of a different direction. And oppositions, as I've learned them and taught them as well, can also be relational. So if you're feeling like you're stuck or you're in a push-pull or it's just not working communication-wise or there's a power struggle with another person, place, or thing, really try and come at that from a different perspective, and it will probably relieve a lot of that tension, okay? Now, as we get to the end of the week, we're jumping all the way to Friday already. We get to the 9th, we're going to see Mercury, who is still in retrograde at this particular point, is going to come into a square with Pluto. Now, we've got Mercury over here in Aries, we've got Pluto over here in Capricorn, and they're squaring at 23 degrees. This, again, both of these planets, when we put Pluto and Mars together in the first place, what can happen is that we do have a little bit of a power struggle. And these two are squaring against each other. So Mars in his action in the desire that's happening, Pluto in the desire to change or to take something down or make it different. They're pushing against each other. So it's like, where are you fighting for control? This could be an energy where you see that. There's some kind of fight for control. There's some kind of push. There's some kind of, Mars is tremendously driven, especially when you interact it with Plutonian energy. So is there someplace that you're pushing and you're trying to drive forward, or are you looking at situations from your past since they are both retrograde and you're seeing where there was maybe a control or a power struggle that was happening? And now as you're coming forward into this energy and under this square, the square is going to demand that you take an action. It says take an action to get us out of this tension. Now you can maybe have a more evolved action or reaction that comes with this. I think it would be really interesting to see if this is a past situation where control was really an issue, where you felt like somebody had dominance over you. What's the action that you're going to take as these two energies come together? The other thing I think that this is profoundly useful for is Mars is a planet of desire and strategy, and Pluto is like, let's take it down. So redo your strategy. Re-look at, recreate, realign with your desire for maybe something that was already in motion. This is a beautiful energy to be able to do that. And that is an easier way to overcome an obstacle than trying to just put your head down and butt through that or try and burn that thing to the ground. Just realign, re-strategize with that thing if you can, okay? As we get to Saturday, October 10th, we're gonna have Venus and Uranus interacting with each other. As these two trine one another, we've got Venus over here in the energy of Virgo. We've got Uranus, of course, in the energy of Taurus. So we've got an Earth trine happening here at 10 degrees. Venus is forward. Uranus is retrograde. So as these two trine each other, love gets exciting. Events get exciting. Social interactions get exciting. They get different. They get unexpected. Something that I keep thinking of is because it's such a fantastic day for this kind of electric love or electric attraction, because Venus is a lot about attraction. One of the things I keep thinking of is that maybe there was even an opportunity or something that you were interacting with in the past, or values that you were living out of in the past that you don't live out of anymore. And now, because you're living out of something different, you're in a different place, you value something differently, this is attracting something to you that is really fun. It's really wonderful. It's a day to enjoy yourself. Go meet unexpected people because they may have an unexpected story to share with you, or maybe you have something unexpected to share with them. It's just, you know, Uranus gets the rap of being erratic and weird and the outlier and all of that, very much so in alignment with Aquarian energy. But sometimes you gotta just, what does Gemini Brett say? Awaken to the weird and allow something good and new and beautiful, or just something different and beautiful to come running into your world. It's lovely. Now, the Sun and Jupiter are gonna square on Sunday the 11th as we're ending this week. And this is, again, I know I'm saying square, and that's usually an angle of tension. I like this. This has always been something that I thought, well, why are we so mad at these two energies squaring with each other? The Sun is as ambitious as Jupiter as is willing to expand. So as these two square one another, and we've already seen this. What did you see? What was happening as they squared back in April? But as these two are squaring each other, you get the opportunity to actually get something done, right? The Sun is like, boom, move, and Jupiter's like, okay, I'm out of retrograde, let's expand. So you get the opportunity to really drive something here. This is optimistic. It is motivated. It is ambitious in the way that it's like, this sets me on fire. This thing feels alive for me in my life like this right now. So you're really genuinely motivated to get something done. Now, I will tell you, because it is the sun and it is willing to be motivated, it is willing to go and is willing to be driven, and because it is Jupiter and he is willing to expand, what you don't want to do is overpromise, underdeliver. Don't overcrowd your plate, because you can do this. You're responding to a square, which is like action, go, let's get out from underneath this tension. So what you could also find, though, is that you take on more than you can actually handle, or more than you'll actually be able to get to. So instead, try and keep it right-sized, review the plan, review the strategy. We've had some of that with Mars. And now take it and go, all right, I'm going to make this really good. I'm going to really respond to this right here, not this way out here. So, and if you have a Sun square Jupiter placement in your chart, I would love to hear how you've worked with that, or what's your experience with that placement. Let me know in the comment section down below, okay? All right, you guys, I think it's going to be a good week, and I think most weeks are going to be a good week, but I think that this is a relatively good week. Little power struggle as we're moving along. Back up, re-strategize. Don't make it bigger than it is. Even if a little something happens, if you're in a little power struggle, don't take that molehill and turn it into a mountain, but don't take that mountain and turn it into a molehill as well. See it for what it is to the very best of your ability. Create a different perspective and a different strategy to navigate around that. And I think we can have a really productive week, okay? All right, you guys, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. If you're not already signed up for a Chutabhava's Nightlife series, the speaker series, I'll be speaking on October 17th, and I would love to see you there. You can get signed up for it. It's absolutely free, but you do have to register so you can get the link, and that'll be in the description box down below, and I'll see you guys over at a Chutabhava space, okay? All right, you guys, I love you. Have a great week. I'll see you next week. Bye.